Abide in Jesus, and ye shall receive power. This is your daily devotional reading.
Gifted through the Spirit, July 16th. Preaching Christ more important than tongues and miracles. How is it then, brethren, when ye come together, every one of you hath a psalm, hath a doctrine, hath a tongue, hath a revelation, hath an interpretation? Let all things be done unto edifying. 1 Corinthians 14 verse 26. There is a great work to be done in our world. Men and women are to be converted, not by the gift of tongues, nor by the working of miracles, but by the preaching of Christ crucified. Why delay the effort to make the world better? Why wait for some wonderful thing to be done, some costly apparatus to be provided? However humble your sphere, however lowly your work, if you labor in harmony with the teachings of the Savior, He will reveal Himself through you, and your influence will draw souls to Him. He will honor the meek and lowly ones who seek earnestly to do service for Him. Into all that we do, whether our work be in the shop, on the farm, or in the office, we ought to bring the endeavor to save souls. We ought to sow beside all waters, keeping our souls in the love of God, working while it is day, using the means entrusted to us in the Master's service. Whatever our hands find to do, we ought to do it with cheerfulness. Whatever sacrifice we are called upon to make, we ought to make it cheerfully. As we sow beside all waters, we shall realize the truth of the words, "He which soweth bountifully shall reap also bountifully." 2 Corinthians 9 verse 6. We owe everything to grace, sovereign grace. Grace ordained our redemption, our regeneration, and our adoption to heirship with Jesus Christ. Let this grace be revealed to others. The Savior takes those whom He finds will be molded and uses them for His own name's glory. He uses material that others would pass by and works in all who will give themselves to Him. He delights to take apparently hopeless material, those whom Satan has debased and through whom he has worked, and make them the subjects of his grace. He rejoices to deliver them from suffering and from the wrath that is to fall upon the disobedient. He makes his children his agents in the accomplishment of this work, and in its success, even in this life, they find a precious reward. Gifted through the Spirit, July 16th.